As an expert in the various martial arts in mm-hmm. China, what did you think of the fighting that you saw in the movies that you studied before you became a star?
Well, I mean, definitely in the beginning, I had no intention or whatsoever that what I was practicing and what I'm still practicing now would lead to this.
Yeah, I know.
To begin with. But martial art has a very, very deep meaning as far as my life is concerned, because as an actor, as a martial artist, as a human being, all these I have learned from martial art.
Maybe for our audience who doesn't know what it means, you might explain exactly
right.
what you mean by
right.
martial art.
Right. Martial art include all the combative arts like karate or
judo.
Karate, judo, Chinese kung fu or Chinese boxing, whatever you call it. All those, you see, like Aikido, Korean, I can go on and on and on, but it's a competitive form of fighting. I mean, it's not, some of them became sport, but some of them are still not. I mean, they use, for instance, kicking to the groin, jabbing fingers at the eyes, and things like that.
No wonder you're successful in it. Chinese movies are full of this kind of action anyway. They needed a guy like you could...
Violence, man.
So you didn't have to use a double when you moved into the motion picture world here. You did it all yourself.
Right.
Can you break five or six pieces of wood with your hand or your foot?
I'll probably break my hand and foot.
But tell me a little bit... you set up a school in Hollywood, didn't you, for people like James Garner and Steve McQueen and the others.
Yes.
Why would they want to learn Chinese martial art? Because of a movie role?
Not really. I mean, most of them, you see, to me, at least the way that when I teach it, all type of knowledge ultimately means self-knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, they're coming in to, and ask me to teach them not so much of how to defend themselves or how to do somebody in, rather, they want to learn to express themselves through some movement, be it anger, be it determination, or whatsoever. So in other words, what I'm saying, therefore, is that he is paying me to show him, in combative form, the art of expressing the human body.
Which is acting, in a sense, isn't it?
Well...
Or it would be a useful tool for an actor to have.
It's, I mean, it might sound too philosophical, but it's acting or acting unacting. If you...
You've lost me.
I have, right? So what I'm saying, actually, you see, I mean, it's a combination of both. I mean, here it is the natural instinct, and here is control. You are to combine the two in harmony. Not if you have one to the extreme, you will be very unscientific. If you have another to the extreme, you become all of a sudden a mechanical man, no longer a human being. So it is a successful combination of both. So therefore, it is not only, it's not pure naturalness or unnaturalness. The ideal is unnatural naturalness or natural unnaturalness.
Yin yang, eh?
Right, man, that's it.
one of your students, James Coburn, played in a movie called Iron Man Flint, in which he used karate. Is that what he learned from you?
He learned it after.
Oh, he went... After he played in Iron Man
Flint. Right. You see, actually, I do not teach, karate, because I do not believe in styles anymore. I mean, I do not believe that there is such thing as, like, Chinese way of fighting or the Japanese way of fighting or whatever way of fighting, because unless human beings have three arms and four legs, we will have a different form of fighting. Mm. But basically, we have only two hands and two feet. So styles tends to not only separate man, because they have their own doctrines, and then the doctrine became the gospel truth, that you cannot change, but if you do not have styles, if you just say, well, here I am, as a human being, how can I express myself totally and completely? Now, that way, you won't create a style, because style is a crystallization, that way, it's a process of continuing growth.
You talk about Chinese boxing. How does it differ from, say, our kind of boxing?
Well, first we use the feet.
That's
and
a
then
start.
We use the elbow. And
do you use the thumb too?
You name it, man. We
use it all.
You have to, you see, because I mean that is the expression of the human body. I mean the everything. I mean, you know, not just the hand. And when you're talking about combat, well, I mean, if it is a sport, now you're talking about something else. You have regulations, yeah. You have rules. But when you're talking about fighting as it is,
no rules.
With no rules,
not real fighting.
Well, then, baby, you better train every part of your body. And when you do punch, now I'm leaning forward a little bit, yeah. Hoping not to hurt any camera angle. Yeah. I mean, you got to put the whole hip into it and snap it and get all your energy in there. And make this into a weapon.
I don't want to tangle you in any dark area. That right now, you came at me pretty fast there. What is the difference between Chinese boxing and what we see these young men doing at 8 o'clock every morning on the rooftops in the parks called shadow boxing, which they're always?
Well, actually, you see, that is part of Chinese boxing.
Yes.
There are so many schools. Different
Everybody
schools.
Here seems to be, you know, going like this all the time.
Well, that's good. I mean, I'm very glad to see that, because at least somebody is caring for their own body, right?
Yeah.
I mean, that's a good sign. Well, it's a kind of a slow form of exercise, which is called Tai Chi Chuan. Uh-huh. I'm speaking Mandarin just now.
Yeah.
Cantonese, Tai Chi Chuan, okay?
I see.
And it's more of an exercise for the elderly. Not so much for the
Give
young.
Me a demonstration. Show me. Can you do a little bit of it? Just
I mean, hand-wise, it's very slow.
Oh, is it?
And you push it out, but all the time you are keeping the continuity going. Bending, stretching, everything. You know, you just keep it moving.
It's like a belly dancer there.
Yeah, it is. I mean, to them, you see, the idea is running water never grows stale. So you got to just keep on flowing.